About 10 years ago, I'm sitting in an architecture office. It was my first week in the profession, and I'm editing some complex drawings. I'm using the techniques I learned from school, such as select individual objects by clicking them, or the window selection, dragging from left to right to select all of the objects that are entirely inside the selection rectangle. Also using the crossing selection from right to left to select all of the objects that are crossed by the selection rectangle. It was not fun. I suffered because I needed more advanced selection tools and I only knew those three ways to select objects. At that time, I remember pointing to YouTube to try to get some help, and sadly, most of the videos I found were people teaching how to select objects using simple circles and lines. Today, I just remembered that bad experience and I don't want you to suffer the same way I did. So here are the selection techniques I learned through the years of working in a professional environment, in this case, an architecture office. Hey guys, my name is Irvin. Welcome to Lazy Architecto, to stop wasting time in AutoCAD. Last week, I answered some of your AutoCAD questions, like how to change XRef transparency and more. So today, I'll give you my ranking for selection commands in AutoCAD. Number 3, select similar. The select similar command finds all objects within the current drawing that match the properties of selected objects, and then adds them to a selection set. This command was introduced in AutoCAD 2011, and it's a very advanced selection technique here in AutoCAD. One of the reasons why I put this command on number 3, it is because it has some limitations. For instance, you won't find this command anywhere here at the ribbon. Simply type select similar on the command line. And again, there is no keyboard shortcut for this command, which is a big issue. But you can go over here on the command line and click the customize icon, and then click or check on the autocomplete. So that way, if you next time type SEL, it will automatically pick the select similar command. Another way to use the select similar command is to select any object. For instance, I'm gonna select this multi-liter, and then right click on it, and then you'll have the option to select similar. As you can see, all of the multiliters were selected in this specific example. Now, how can we change some of the settings that we use with the select similar command? For example, if I select this hatch over here and do a select similar, again, you can see that it will select all of the objects on this hatch, even though they are in different layers. As you can see, if I go to the property palette, the layer, it says various because, again, this is in a layer hatch brick, and this other one, it's on a layer hatch brick new. So how can I customize the settings for the select similar to only select the brick hatch that it's in the same layer? Well, for this, you need to first start the select similar command without selecting any object. So let's type again select similar SEL and press enter, And once you do that, you have here in the command line a settings option. So simply click on it. So here, these are the settings. And basically right now, it's only name is checked, which means a hatch with the pattern name brick is being selected. It's not taking into consideration what layer is this hatch on. So if I want to change that behavior, I'm gonna check the layer option and click OK. So that way, when I select this hatch or brick hatch and press enter, you will see that it will only select the other brick hatch that are on the same layer. So if I go home, you can see it says hatch brick and the new brick wasn't selected. AutoCAD selection command number 2, filter command. This command creates a list of requirements that an object must meet to be included in a selection set. So if we type filter here at the command line, you can also use its keyboard shortcut FI to access the filter command. So once you do that, you have this powerful dialog box. So for this specific example, I'm gonna select all of the objects that have color blue on this specific drawing because I want to change that color so it prints darker in my drawing based on my plot style. So the way I'm gonna do is type C a couple of times to go right into the color option. Once I have it, I'm gonna select it, and then I'm gonna select here, pick to select the color blue, and then I click OK. Once I do that, I'm gonna click add to the list right here, and then I'm gonna hit apply. Now at this point, I can select all of my objects, or I can simply type all and press enter. Now I have to press enter again one more time, and boom, as you can see, only the objects that are blue were selected. So now I can simply change layers or change colors as you wish. Now let's try another example to also see some of the limitations of the filter command, and this is why I put it on my number 2 on this AutoCAD selection commands rank. So let's again use the FI for the filter shortcut. And so here, if you want to start fresh, you have to select whatever filter you previously added and delete. So now everything is clean and you can start again. So one of the limitations of the filter command is that you are restricted by only the options that are here available under the select filter. For instance, if you want to select all of the circles that have a specific radius size, you can see that under circles you have that option. So once you specify it, and then you can say a radius equal or less or more than, you know, a number 5 inches or whatever, you can do that. However, there are many other options that you are not allowed to do. For instance, if I type P to select the polyline, you can see that there is no option to select by polyline length, which is something very useful. The only option here is polyline, but there is no polyline length associated to it. So this is why we need an even more advanced AutoCAD selection tool. So let's go to my number 1 selection command in AutoCAD, which is the quick select command. So the quick select command creates a selection set based on a filtering criteria. So to access the quick select command or Q select, you can find it here at the ribbon on the home tab, and going here under utilities, you can see it over here, quick select, or you can also use the QS shortcut if you have again your autocomplete options here on the command line. So again, QS and press enter. And here is the quick select command. And basically, this command is so powerful. First, I'm gonna start with a simple selection and then go to a more advanced selection that actually one of you guys asked me on a comment on another video. So here I can go to an entire drawing to apply my selection, or I can simply click this icon to specify that I want to analyze only this specific area of my drawing. And once I press enter, you can see it says current selection. Let's say here, for instance, I'm gonna select all of my multiliters on these specific objects. And you can go even farther to select by layers, and then let's say you do equals to a anodim. And if you press OK, of course, nothing will be selected because my multiliters layer is not on a anodim. So for this specific example, I'm gonna simply say multiliter and then select all. So make sure include in new selection set is checked, and then click OK. As you can see, all of my multiliters were selected quickly and efficiently. Now, let me give you a more advanced example. And for this, I'm gonna go to Mohammed Hamed. He asked, is there a Lisp to filter out polyline having length from 2 meter to 5 meter and having area from 2 square meter to 5 square meter? Well, Mohammed, you don't need a Lisp for this. You can use the quick select command, and let me show you its power. So I worked in imperial units here in the United States, so I'm gonna explain it in imperial units, but it's gonna be the same idea. Basically, what Mohammed is asking is to be able to select a pulling line using the length as well as the area. So we're gonna do that. For this, I'm gonna show you this random rectangle or polylines that I drew. So, you know, basically they have different areas in square inches as well as length in inches and feet. So again, we're gonna start the QSELECT command, and here you're gonna see how powerful this quick select command is. To start, I'm gonna say apply to the entire drawing. And here on the object type, I'm gonna pick polyline. And then on the properties, I'm gonna type or press L to go straight to the length. Once I have it selected, I'm gonna pick, in this example, polylines greater than 1. And then I'm gonna click OK. As you can see, everything was selected. Why? Because all of these rectangles has a greater length than 1. Here is the trick. So without doing anything, simply press enter again, and you can see that the quick select is now using the current selection. Again, I'm gonna go to the length option, and this time I'm gonna say less than, because that's what Mohammed is asking, to select values for the length that are greater and less than a certain number. So we're gonna say less than 5 inches in this case, and I'm gonna click OK. So once I do that, you can see that only two of these polylines or rectangles were selected. And again, I'm gonna press enter again because Mohammed is also asking that these rectangles have a certain area. So we're gonna use the same procedure here, and we're gonna say A for area. And again, we're gonna say greater than, in this case, for this specific example, I'm gonna say 1 and click OK. And both are selected because they have greater areas than 1 square inch. So I'm gonna press enter again. And lastly, I'm gonna pick area again. And we're gonna say less than. And for this specific example, I'm gonna say 5 square inches. So once I click that, again, both rectangles or polylines are the only rectangles that have a length that are between 1 and 5 inches in length, as well as a area between 1 and 5 square inches. Hey, I hope these selection techniques can help you stop wasting time in AutoCAD. Here is another wonderful AutoCAD technique, so I'll see you over there to explain it.